Year where we saw tax on Asian Americans, Seattle's International District is now taking a bold step.
Business owners developed a new Seattle Chinese American Chamber of Commerce to address safety concerns. And Q13 News reporter Frankie Thompson was at the first meeting.
And it kind of peaks and then it goes away.
It does.
Sharing food, culture, and ideas. That's how business owners in the International District hope to revitalize this historic part of Seattle.
There's that light of hope. And that we have to capitalize on that light of hope right now with relationship building, clearing the misunderstandings, again, showing love and support for one another.
Entrepreneur David Leong says the positive momentum is long awaited. He says the CID experienced discrimination, hate, and violence for the last year and a half.
Misunderstandings, anger, frustration. Then you throw the pandemic on top of that, and that hits so hard and so fast.
Overcoming anti-Asian sentiment encouraged them to start the Seattle Chinese American Chamber of Commerce. In their first meeting, members discussed plans to promote all things good about the neighborhood and its safety.
Make sure that our citizens here feel safe and have an atmosphere of safety. Now, there's obviously some hurdles that we have to go through and we have to dig beyond, but we can do that. We've seen this before.
The Seattle Police Department and Mayor's Office are partners supporting the chamber, rebuilding the community and its confidence. Captain P.L. Davis says department liaisons will be helping this effort.
Open and honest collaboration, that willingness to step up and say something when you feel something's not right, or even hold us to task when we're not as transparent as we need to be.
As the new chamber talks about goals for the CID, Leong says he hopes discouragement from the pandemic won't dictate their optimistic future.
Every state, every city is going through very similar issues like we are in Seattle. And I think that if we really think rationally and approach this situation in a calm and respectful way, that we're gonna make some headway. And it's baby steps, okay? And I think the key thing is fairness. Fairness for all.
Frankie Thompson, Q13 News.
The mayor's office says 2,000 ORCA cards will go to grocery and restaurant workers in the CID and Pioneer Square. The voter-approved initiative is to help people get back to work and recover from the pandemic.